Water boils at 373. That's so weird. Oh, what was I gonna say?
Well, yeah, it would be a lot more precise, like when you're trying to give a boiling point or something.
Yeah. It's technically impossible to have a negative Kelvin. Because there's nothing. Once you freeze hydrogen, there's nothing colder than that. Like, you can't take the temperature lower to freeze it deeper. The lightest element in your tree is frozen. There's nothing else colder. Okay, and apparently if you touch frozen hydrogen, you will burn yourself. Does that make sense to you guys? If you touch
Yes.
frozen hydrogen, you burn yourself.
Yes.
Because it's basically boiling. So if you touch something that's boiling, it's giving off heat from the reaction. Even though it's colder, you like freaking burn your finger. So it's in the sense that if a negative temperature system and a positive temperature system come in contact, heat will flow from the negative to the positive temperature system. Weird. It's saying like negative Kelvins are positive on Fahrenheit. It doesn't make sense.
Okay.
This math is stupid.
What are you doing, Christian?
Oh God. The absolute hot. is 1.4 something times 10 to the 32nd Kelvin. That is hot. In the grand scheme of things, Earth is a frozen planet, comparing how hot things can get. I'm just rambling. When you're in absolute hot, the molecules are spread so far apart that if you enter the atmospheres, your molecules instantly split. You, in a sense, disintegrate if you go anywhere near that absolute hot point. Yeah. When a temperature starts getting freaking, like, super hot, like...
Wait, what are you guys talking about now?
I'm talking about absolute hot.
Are you still on the same subject?
Yeah, I decided to look up the other spectrum. It's like 1.8 times 10 to the 32nd Kelvin.
Okay, that's cool.
I'm bored. I'm so bored. I'm so bored. So I'm going to speak in funny voices. Oh my god. I don't know what I want to do. Young friend list. Is he open online? Come on, people, log on. Blah. So, I want to get freaking singing lessons. Because I suck at singing. And I want to get better. You guys are boring. Like, I want to talk to somebody. Because I'm bored. No, I'm off that subject. I want to talk about something else. I'm sorry. What was I going to say? Oh my god. Do you guys know anything about, like, vocal ranges?
About what?
Vocal ranges?
No.
No.
Like, what do you mean?
Like
notes?
Yeah, like notes. Like how people can hit high notes and low notes and have big ranges.
Yeah, and how there's like an international pentascale.
Pentatonic scale. The average person has a 2-octave speaking voice.
Yeah, and I can pick up on notes like automatically worldwide.
Huh. What do you mean, notes automatically worldwide?
Like, just anybody, it's universal, the pentatonic scale or whatever.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter where you're at in the world. Like, hold on.
Vocal range on it.
Like, I'll give you an example.
Well, the average vocal range is 2 octaves, according to what I've looked up.
Like this right here.
Okay, let me see.
If you know anything about neuroscience, that's pretty handy.